A great learning tool for demonstrating maintenance and troubleshooting. The glass-faced pump provides a unique view of the liquid and air dynamics occurring within a self-priming centrifugal pump. Before initiating a reprime cycle, a self-priming centrifugal pump requires at least half of its casing to be filled with water. As the pump is energized, the impeller turns in a counterclockwise rotation. The water in the pump is slung through the volute scroll into the discharge chamber inside the volute. During a priming cycle, the pump uses water to create a hydrodynamic seal between the impeller vanes and the wear plate. In this demonstration, the glass panel represents the wear plate. After the hydrodynamic seal in the pump is created, the internal pressure inside the pump drops below the pressure outside the pump. The pressure on the surface of the liquid in the tank forces water into the suction pipe. For each foot of vacuum the pump generates, atmospheric pressure will push the water up the suction pipe by 1 foot. As the column of water travels towards the pump, it forces the preceding column of air into the impeller. As the air and water mixture enters the center, or eye, of the spinning impeller, centrifugal force throws the mixture to the outer diameter of the impeller, where it enters the water channel and is then expelled into the discharge chamber. At this stage, the air separates from the water and exits the pump either through an open-ended line or an air release device. The water within the pump casing is rerouted through a recirculation port back to the impeller, sustaining the hydrodynamic seal. This cycle continues until the pump is primed.